Hi there, and welcome to another episode of Soul Aligned Success. Today I'm going to talk to you on how to write soul aligned copy, really magnetize your message, and call in your soulmate clients. So this is probably my favorite topic to talk about. I'm so excited to share with you how to write soul-aligned copy, really magnetize your message online, and call in your soulmate clients. So this has been a process for me, and this started back in 2014 when I opened to channeling in a very profound way, very much how Abraham Hicks opened up and started channeling Abraham. That's how my guide started to come through to me and started to move my mouth to certain syllables, and I started to form a relationship with spirit in a very profound way, a two-way conversation, really. Most of my clairs are open. I'm very clairaudient, though. That's probably one of my primary, very clairaudient and claircognizant. And so I hear spirit very easily, and I'm able to translate that into words that really resonate with people, and that's one of my gifts. But we all have these gifts. We are all open channels, especially if you are a spiritual teacher, healer, light worker, or coach, and you are feeling called to share your message and share your gift with the world. And I'm going to share with you one of the frustrations that I see happening. So a lot with my clients and all the women that I hop on the phone with all the time, this is what's happening. And maybe you can relate to this. You're receiving the download. You're receiving the guidance, you're receiving the wisdom, and then you don't take action on it. Okay, so I want you to think about, or maybe you take action on it, but it's way later, it's like after you've put it in your journal and sat on it for weeks or months or something like that. And I want you to think about the energetic frequency of when you received the download, how fired up you were about it, or how clear it was, and how powerful it felt, and the energetic vibration around the download when you received it versus when you post it, if you post it down the road or later. And you'll probably notice that it doesn't have the same energetic charge to it anymore. It's not carrying like that same frequency. And so one takeaway I'm going to leave you with today is to act on those intuitive downloads, however you're receiving the information, as quickly as you can and in the moment, honoring this process to be a divine channel, to be a conduit and a vessel for spirit to work through you, which is really what's happening. And so back to my story in 2014, when I started to open up to channeling, at first I was like, what's going on? This was like a year after my spiritual awakening, and it was super profound. Obviously, I told some people, but most people I didn't tell. And I just sort of, you know, worked with this energy and started to ask myself, okay, how can I put this to highest and best use? How can this be put to the highest and greatest good for everyone? Like, what is this gift for? Like, obviously it's not happening on accident. It's not happening just by chance. Like, I'm receiving this guidance to share for a reason, right? And so what I like to teach my clients inside Sacred Leader Academy is how to open up this divine channel, how to really open up to the channeling process, honor the divine guidance that's coming through, honor this path of service that you're opening up to, answering the call to being of higher service, and trusting the guidance and the downloads that are coming through. So often I see spiritual entrepreneurs, teachers, healers, lightworkers receiving the guidance, but then failing to take action on it because they don't trust the guidance that's coming through. Or they're stuck in their own fear demons, like imposter syndrome or perfectionism or procrastination and things like that are the byproduct of this fear, right? So then they don't take action, and the message sits in their journal for days, weeks, months, or years, and the message never gets out there. Here's something I want to bring to your attention. When you receive messages and you receive guidance, This is the reason you're receiving it is because someone else is meant to hear it. And when you can step forward with courage and share the messages, and even though it may be scary sometimes and make yourself feel very vulnerable, when you share your messages that are coming to you and through you, that are meant to come to you and through you out into the world, in whichever platform, in whichever vehicle, whichever mode makes the most sense to you, right? So whether that's through written format, audio format, or video format, whatever makes sense to you. But when you honor that process and you step into your purpose work and you allow yourself to be this vessel and this channel of divine will, you will automatically magnetize your message online, and you're automatically attracting in your soulmate clients through this process now that I call the lighthouse effect. By you shining your light so brightly, sharing your message, everyone that's within vibrational frequency that's meant to hear your message is magically going to find you. This is when you start to have people pop into your DMs and say, oh my God, I just listened to your video and it totally resonates with me. I feel like you're talking to my soul. How do I work with you? Or they'll post comments to your videos, and these are the ones that will have a lot of engagement as well. And not all engagement is public, because a lot of people don't want to post their comments publicly, but they'll DM you, right? So this is where you really are connecting soul to soul. This is where you're really like 5D communication. You're receiving on the spiritual level. You're allowing yourself to be this conduit and this channel for divine will, for this information to flow to you and through you. And it is like literally going out into this energetic ethers, and your ideal soulmate clients are getting the nudge to go check Instagram, or to go to Facebook, or to click on a video that they normally don't click on, or to click on a hashtag they normally don't click on, and then all of a sudden that leads them to you. This happens all the time when you are showing up in your power, owning your truth, trusting your guidance, trusting the wisdom, trusting the divine, trusting the journey, trusting the process, right? So there's a lot of trust involved. Really opening up to this channeling, stepping onto this path of the priestess, the high priestess, connecting with your intuitive guidance system, and allowing the wisdom to pour to you and through you. Okay, this is where people will hear your message or read your message or watch your video and be like, wow, this is really resonating with me. And if you'd like to get started with this process, then I'm going to share with you one little takeaway, another one, and that is to call it in, right? You can call in this divine guidance, but then you also have to create the sacred space to hold it and receive it, all right? And so that's a whole nother video we're not going to get into right now, but this is a process that when you work this process, it works like magic, and it's a formula that you can rinse and repeat, because spirit is on your side guiding you, and spirit is ready for you to step into this and allow this and receive this and take action on this, right? But you can call it in. So set your intentions in the morning. Spirit, how, please use me. How, show me where I need to go, what I need to do, what do I need to say? How can I be of best use today? What message needs to come through to me? Please make it clear. Please show me. I'm willing to take the actions. I'm willing to take the steps. I'm willing to get out of my comfort zone. I'm willing to step through the fear. I'll share the messages. Please show me. Please share with me what needs to come through. These are intentions and mantras that I work with constantly. I'm constantly working with my spirit team to stay open as a channel to receive, so that I can then deliver the messages in whichever way seems most in alignment with me at that time. There was a day when I would receive these messages and sit on them, and they would just pile up and pile up in my journal. And this is, so I'm no exception to this rule, but once you really, honor this process and step into this process, things are going to open up for you very, very quickly, because now you are in alignment with the highest will of all. You are in alignment with divine will, and you are stepping onto a path of service, service to others, service to yourself first and foremost, and then service to others, because you always want to be giving from a full cup, right? And that's a whole nother video as well. But this is what I wanted to leave you with today. If you're trying to create a consistent way to create magnetic content online that really calls in your soulmate clients and really resonates with the souls of the people who desperately need your gift and your message. So if you're liking this information, I would love it if you leave me a comment below. And if you're really interested in this process, then I would invite you to hop on my Soul Aligned Success Masterclass. And you can find that in the link in my bio at Instagram at Spiritual CEO, or you can find it below this video wherever you happen to be watching it. And I hope this video finds you well. Until the next episode, namaste.